like to open up out of Genesis chapter 2, where it says, "So the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh at that place, and the Lord God fashioned into a woman the rib which he had taken from the man, and brought her to the man. And the man said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. For this cause a man shall leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh.'" We are gathered here today on this most happy occasion to join together in holy matrimony, Brandon Dobson and Ashley Miller. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? You may be seated. You're gathered in the sight of God and in the presence of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a holy institution established in heaven by the divine wisdom and kindness of God, who said that it is not good for man to be alone, but I will make for him a helpmate. And who again said, "Then two shall be one." Christ Jesus, the Son of God, honored and sanctified the wedding in Cana of Galilee with his presence. And it was here that he brought forth his first miracle, and he brought cheer and joy to the host and his entire assembled guests, and thus beautifying this earthly union with the first recorded manifestation of his miracle-working power. He saw in it a symbol of the day to come when he himself is the blessed heavenly bridegroom of the church, should lead his own beloved among men to the great marriage supper of the Lamb, that God the Father himself has ordained shall be celebrated when the victory of the cross shall have been consummated. In creation, Adam, the man, was first formed, then the woman, Eve. And the scriptures tell us that the woman might be for the man, setting forth the humility, the modesty, and the gentleness that should characterize her kind. Yet man, being made last of all of God's creatures, was set forth as the best and the most excellent of all of God's creative works. So Eve's being made after Adam and out of him sets an honor upon the woman as being the glory of the man. If the man is the head, she is the crown of her husband. The man was dust refined, but the woman was doubly refined, one step further from the earth. In being created from man or out of man, she was not out of his head to dominate or to be over him, nor out of his feet to be under him or to be trampled upon by him, but out of his side to be equal with him, from under his arm to be protected by him, and near to his heart to be loved by him. Brandon, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's holy ordinances in a holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort and honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live? If so, just say, "I will." Ashley, repeat after me. Ashley, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's holy ordinances in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him as you long and as you shall live? If so, just say, "I will." Okay, Brandon, now you have some personal vows in your heart that you'd like to present to Ashley.
Get here. All right. Sorry if it's, I'm crying here. All right, so Ashley, stand in front of our friends and family. I feel like Nick is going to win. I get to start this next chapter of my life with my best friend on my side. Seeing you walk down, hearing butterflies, just like it was the first time. I vow from this day forward to make your feelings of our relationship priority. I vow to be a father to you and Mia. We guide them through life. I vow to love, cherish, and protect you. I vow to be a shoulder for you to cry on. There's a reason for you to laugh. I vow to never stop being with me and fall in love with. But I love you with all my heart. This is our story, all we've left for us to live.
Okay. Brandon, I'm going to speak slowly. I want you to repeat after me, but I want you to look at Ashley because you're marrying her and not me. Okay, I'll get right up there. I, Brandon, take thee, Ashley.
I, Brandon, take thee, Ashley.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's. According to God's. Friendly ordinances. I pledge my fidelity. Ashley, you have vows that you would like to present to Brandon.
B, I knew from the very moment I laid eyes on you, you were my forever. Some way, somehow, I knew you were mine. From this day forward, my heart is entirely yours. As we continue to grow in our lives together, I promise to give you all of my words when needed, and to share in the silence when they are not, to pick you up if you are down, to love you unconditionally, to lay my bare skin on you when needed the most, to care for you and our family as long as we live, to adventure with you, to always say I love you before falling asleep each night, to be the best mom I can be, as we grow together as a family, and to always know in the deepest part of my soul that when challenges arise, we will always find our way back to one another. You are my everything, and this is my promise to you. I love you.
Ashley, can you repeat after me? I, Ashley, take thee, Brandon.
I, Ashley, take thee, Brandon.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinances, I pledge my fidelity. Okay, if somebody has the ring. Okay, you have selected these rings as a token of your marriage covenant. They are made of gold, which is a type that is least tarnished and most enduring. Fitting represent the ties that bind the husband and the wife. The ring is an endless circle that is to remain intact until broken by some outside force. It is a symbol of the unbroken union, which is to continue until broken by death. Brandon, take this ring and place it upon the left ring finger of Ashley and let it be a seal of your mutual fidelity and affection and a memorial to this sacred service today. Repeat after me. With this ring,
I do
thee wed. With all my worldly goods,
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Ashley, if you could take this ring and place it upon Brandon's left ring finger and let it be a seal of your mutual fidelity and affection and memorial to this sacred service today and repeat after me with this ring.
With this ring.
I do thee wed.
I do thee wed.
With all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Well, let me speak to your hearts. I charge you both as you hope for happiness in your married life to be true to these vows that you have made to each other with your marriage. From this day, you begin life anew with larger responsibilities. Brandon, guard well this bride of yours who now commits herself into your keeping and so strive to live in the Lord that no word or deed of yours shall cloud her brow with grief or dim her eyes with tears. And Ashley, it will be your part to strive to retain by your virtues the heart that you have won by your graces. And to both of you, I would say, let not your voices lose the tender tones of affection, nor your eyes forget the tender rays with which they have shone in courtship day, the greatest of all, that God be enthroned above all else in all times. Now, having heard you make these pledges of your affection and taking these vows of fidelity, I do, by the authority conferred upon me by the Church of Jesus Christ and by the laws of the State of Ohio, pronounce you husband and wife, no longer two, but now one, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to whom God is joined together. Let no man put asunder. I am happy to present to you.
He got him.
He got him. Facial roll.
Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Dobson, you may now kiss your new bride.
Woo-hoo!